And as you know, generally speaking, former mayors are generally speaking. So I'm going to go from the particular cases that have been enumerated and described by previous speakers to a more general theory and but vivid description of the struggle in which we find ourselves. There are some operational rules of political power. You get it, you use it, you keep it, and you expand it. Team Obama has his sights set or trained on pulling off the greatest realignment of political power our generation has ever witnessed. And they are executing this general theory and strategy on about six fronts. First is card check, or falsely, the act falsely labeled the Employee Free Choice Act. Conservative words, liberal agenda. What they attempt to do with card check is chip away at the moral grip of the secret ballot. If in fact you do away with the secret ballot in the workplace, who knows what you will accept in the ballot booth. But more importantly, this is a way to infuse billions of new dollars, soft dollars, into the political process to further advance the left's agenda. They will do this by doubling or tripling union membership in the next decade. Secondly, the censorship doctrine, falsely labeled as the fairness doctrine. The objective there is to choke off dissenting opinion in the political marketplace. I think that we have attacked this in a way that's too narrow. We shouldn't just be worrying about those talk show hosts, big and small across the country. We should be offering an initiative on another front called the freedom to listen. The consumers of opinion, those who choose to listen to Rush Limbaugh, Sean Hannity, Lincoln Ware, and others, should have that freedom. The third point is blanket amnesty for 12 million illegal immigrants. The fourth point will be the universal same-day voter registration offered last year by Senator Russ Feingold. I would suggest to you that it's going to come back during this session of Congress. The fifth action will be to take advantage of an opportunity that the Bush administration has left on the table, and that is to pack the federal courts at the appellate level. Last year, the appellate courts dealt with about 60,000 cases. I would suggest to you that in packing the courts, they will have a substantial impact on voter ID and a whole host of other things that impact the quality of our electoral process. The census, which is so important to not only apportioning seats in Congress, but to redrawing district lines in each of our 50 states. Taken individually, these things are dangerous in and of themselves. Taken collectively, you can begin to see the game plan for the left and for the Obama administration. The answer is, how will we answer the call as conservatives? When I was growing up, my dad was a boxing fanatic, and he entered me into the Gold Gloves at age 14. I won my first 5 bouts with relative ease. 5th bout, I got hit so hard in the nose, I had to go home and tell my dad I was going to find a more scholarly career to pursue. I stayed away from boxing arenas until I was a freshman in college when Father E.J. O'Connor, a 72-year-old Jesuit, former Marine, asked me and a Jewish friend of mine, Benji Schwartz, to go to the Golden Gloves amateur boxing matches with him at the old Cincinnati Garden. We watched 10 bouts. The 11th bout, a young boy, he too of Irish Catholic heritage, came out before his bout. He made the sign of the cross. Benji elbowed Father and said, "Father, what's the significance of that?" Father said, "Son, it's important, but it ain't enough if he can't fight." Whether it's the particular or the particulars or the general, what we've mapped out for you in our presentation is a description of the battle in front of us. It's a battle of power. It's a battle of political representation. It's a battle of the nature of our relationship to our government as individuals. And it's actually about the nature of our culture. Ladies and gentlemen, all of the analysis and descriptions in the world ain't enough if we're not capable and willing to fight. This is a battle cry.